I am getting an education this morning, want to include you in the conversation. This is Dr. Ben Wilkinson with Provision Care's Proton Therapy out of Knoxville, kind enough to drive into Chattanooga this morning, so thank you for that.
Thank you for having me.
Kind of a reverse trip, actually, because a lot of our neighbors here in Chattanooga drive up to Knoxville to see you. You've been at the center now for about a year.
Yes.
Have long experience with the proton therapy. Explain to us what that is, and then we're going to dig in a little bit deeper to how it benefits people so much.
Yes, proton therapy is an advanced form of cancer therapy that takes regular radiation to a new level. We're able to target areas of the body with a higher degree of precision and with fewer side effects because we don't have the exit and scatter radiation dose that we do with a regular radiation machine.
So like you were just explaining to me as we were heading out of the commercial, with breast cancer specifically, you always look, if a woman or a man has breast cancer on the left side, the Provision proton therapy can be so beneficial because it allows you to bypass the heart, mm-hmm. which you otherwise may touch.
Radiation in general travels in a straight line, and so when we treat breast cancer, whether it is a female or a male, and we're treating on the left side, or if we're having to treat lymph nodes, those lymph nodes run very close to the heart, and we would like to avoid them with regular radiation, but just the physics don't allow us to do that. So proton therapy allows us to deliver the dose to the tumor site, mm-hmm. or the area that might be at risk for tumor cells, and then spare the surrounding area. So it's not always just the heart, but also the lung, the chest wall, and even the esophagus where our food travels to prevent having swallowing issues afterwards.
We won't be able to touch on everything because clearly it's a long conversation, a whole show we could do on this. But a lot of your patients, most of them, come to you every day for about 4 to 6 weeks. Some families choose just to drive in mm-hmm. daily, but you also work with hotels there in the Knoxville area so that people can come and just stay for the week to make it more convenient.
I would say at least a third of our patients that we treat in Knoxville come from outside of a 60 to 90 mile area. Mm-hmm. And at this point, we've treated patients from 23 different states that have traveled in, including international patients as well. Because it's such a long period of time, the need for being in town really does help patients because even though we are able to reduce side effects, sometimes patients can feel tired. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, some patients view this as their proton therapy vacation. They'll come and enjoy the area of the East Tennessee. So if they're mm-hmm. not from the Chattanooga area, they're coming and enjoying the mountains and the rivers, you know, that we have to offer.
You look, though, very much to try to reduce the side effects. And I know you've been using the fact that this is a radiation. A lot of people are afraid of that. You know, you hear about the side effects of radiation.
Yeah.
This is a little bit more minimal.
It is.
Less invasive.
Yeah, so we never either want to get radiation or give radiation unless we have to, but this is the safest way that we can do that.
Mm-hmm.
Because proton therapy is a particle, it travels to a set distance into the body depending on the dose that we prescribe. And then we can guarantee that within 8 to 10 millimeters past that point, there's no additional radiation dose. So it allows us to aim a proton beam right at a tumor and then completely spare an organ that might be just a centimeter or two on the other side of that space.
Widely used in Europe before it came to the United States, but well-known organizations, Loma Linda, MD Anderson, the Mayo Clinic, Harvard, mm-hmm. all have utilized this, so it's not a new approach.
It started in the 1960s to treat brain tumors. However, in the 1980s in Boston and then 1990, Loma Linda opened up. Since that time, we now have 26 active proton centers in the United States, mm-hmm. Including ours. And we are set to open, as you mentioned, the second center that's going to be in Middle Tennessee beginning next year.
I'm sure that when you sit down with a family, and often it's not just the patient, it's the family, they're all in this together, they want to know, well, what are your results?
So we would expect the same results, and that's what's been published by the centers that have been open at a longer time point. So when we look at prostate cancer, University of Florida has published their results at 5 years for both the 8-week and the 5-week treatment options.
Mm-hmm.
And the disease control rates are the same, if not better, than we have historically seen for regular radiation.
You also had told me when we just were meeting earlier this morning, that some people will come to you even as like a pre-diagnostic if they've had a high PSA level test or something.
So our campus offers a comprehensive approach where we discuss patients in a multidisciplinary tumor conference. Mm-hmm. And even if there's a suspicion, or especially a high suspicion, that there might be a cancer, whether it's a high PSA or a change in PSA, a mammogram that's now abnormal, or maybe an MRI that someone came across when they went into the emergency room for something, you know, that was unrelated. Mm-hmm. They'll come in for consultation with us and we talk about the treatment options. That may not involve proton therapy. It might involve conventional radiation, chemotherapy, surgery, or sometimes nothing. Sometimes active surveillance is something that we can do. And it definitely gives a peace of mind to know that they've looked at all the different options, including a technology like proton therapy that's available at, you know, as you mentioned, the largest cancer centers in the country.
So then if you're someone who maybe has a recent diagnosis and you're not sure where to turn, if first of all, you can self-refer, mm-hmm. no need for your doctor to send you. Once they're there in your doors, then do you counsel with them and say, of all the different options that we have for you, this is what we think is the best?
Yes, and so we have conventional radiation on campus, but we also have proton therapy as well. And so we'll give them a treatment plan, which may or may not involve radiation at all, but it does give them that comfort that they've gone through that process. And I think that, not to say that someone's initial opinion isn't a great medical opinion, mm-hmm. it just, when it's something that's as important as cancer, it's nice to have an additional set of eyes looking through everything. Mm-hmm. And there are newer techniques that are out there, like genomic testing that many patients have not heard of, or advanced MRI imaging that we might recommend. There's a terrific MRI specialist that's here in Chattanooga that we use a lot, Dr. Joseph Bush. Mm-hmm. And so many of our patients, you mentioned, drive up to Knoxville, but we also have a lot of our patients in Knoxville that will drive down to see him.
And real quickly before I let you go, do you encourage families and friends to come? Do you need that support of people to listen and really take in the advice being
given? I think
given?
It always helps to bring someone with you just to take notes. And I encourage patients to record our conversation because mm-hmm. and in the moment, it feels like you're, you know, there's a lot of information that's coming at you. We do try to go very slowly and explain what we're going to recommend. Typically, a consultation will last an hour, or even an hour and a half, which might feel very different than other doctor's appointments. But because there are so many details to talk through with cancer care, we feel it's important to spend that time.
It's a shame that so many people find themselves in a position to need what you have to offer. But prostate cancer, breast cancer, head and neck cancer specifically seem to benefit from this.
Yeah, brain tumors, lung tumors, and unfortunately sometimes we even treat children, so pediatric cases can often benefit from protons as well.
The easiest thing will be to go online, provisionproton.com. There you can learn more about them, get their phone number, and make your appointment when you need it. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
We're back after this.